What's up, guys? It's Hot Take Jake, your Deep Six champion, here for another week of hot takes. So, I don't watch wrestling, but I did watch the draft on SmackDown, and it was just as bad as you would expect. So most of my hot takes are going to pertain to that. I got a couple other ones, but let's dive into some hot takes. Let's start at the beginning. Roman versus Seth is really boring, but that's not my hot take. My hot take is the spear is a lame finisher. I don't think it looks good. I think Roman should bring back the Razor's Edge powerbomb. It was a much better finisher, and it actually looks like it might have hurt somebody. The spear is like a gentle tackle. Moving on, still on Roman though. Roman should set up a match with Troy Aikman for Mania. I heard he uses the pile driver a lot.
What was your finishing move in the ring?
Probably my go-to has always been the pile driver. It's not my signature move because it came before me,
right?
But it was effective nonetheless.
And kind of in the same vein as that. So I'm pretty sure the only reason Robbie Rott likes WWE is because he's never watched good wrestling before. Here's a little fun fact. He's never seen a Kenny Omega match, which means he's never seen real wrestling at its greatest.
My son of a bitch! Oh, come here. You son of a bitch!
Now, onto my favorite wrestler, Drew Gulak. Now that Gulak is on SmackDown, he's probably never going to have a good match ever again. Rest in peace until his contract runs out and he moves to AEW like everyone else. So I think Fox needs to bring the Fox robot to SmackDown more. I think that's really the most entertaining part of the draft, was watching the Fox robot high-five people. Whether he was CG or a man in a costume or a real robot, whatever they're doing, I want more of it. Another hot take. I think if Gable versus Corbin ended with the match they had last night, it would have actually been a really good feud. But if you look at Lacey versus Natalya, it's going to go on for probably 8 more weeks. Talking about Lacey and Natalya, Lacey and Natalya are now in separate brands just to set up for the Survivor Series match. I really think they're going to push that feud cross-promotion. The Fiend showing up on TV. The Fiend is already ruined because he's been on TV. Him showing up in the opening match of SmackDown to kind of render the entire clause useless kind of just ruins him as a character. I'm not happy about that. We also got, I really hope that Lashley cucks Rusev across brands.
Hey Rusev, listen up, man. It doesn't look like you're having a good time at all, man. And you don't look even nearly as comfortable as I do. I mean, look at me. The robe? It looks familiar, doesn't it? It's your robe, Rusev.
They put him on separate brands. They haven't talked about where Lana's going or if Lana's even a wrestler anymore. But I really hope that Lashley brings Lana with him and cucks Rusev from across brands.
It looks like you're not having fun.
But I am.
No, we are.
If WWE doesn't, so there's been some rumors floating around that the draft might have already been leaked. And if WWE doesn't follow the rumors and draft Titus O'Neil as a round one draft pick, I'm pretty sure they've already lost AEW. Titus O'Neil is the one thing keeping them from being better than AEW. And my last personal hot take for the week. I'm really loving Kofi's new gimmick, where he just hands out titles to people. First, he handed the title to Brock Lesnar, and he handed out 2 more titles, the breast cancer titles. I think it's a great gimmick. I think he should hand out a title every week. He should take AJ's title just to hand it out to someone else. So with that, we mentioned last week that we're going to do some fan hot takes. So I have a couple written down right here I'm going to go through. So the first one, Cody Rhodes is this generation's Jeff Jarrett. He was a mid-card wrestler in the 2 biggest promotions, so he started his own. That comes from user Proclamation. A proclamation is spelled wrong. I mean, you're not wrong. He did kind of just start his own promotion, but it's good. Probably, Pat, what did Jeff Jarrett start? Was he TNA?
Yeah.
So I think AEW is already better than TNA.
Oh, and Global Force Wrestling.
It's better than TNA, but not better than Global Force Wrestling. Our next fan hot take, Lucky Cannon from the NXT game show should have been a star. Honestly, I think they should have pushed everyone from that game show. And at this point, why don't they just bring it back? Like, they're getting rid of 205. They might as well just make a new game show. It's kind of the direction they're going, where nothing really matters.
I was severely injured when I was hit in the back of the head with a lead pipe. I got Bayflighted and was in a coma for 3 weeks.
That comes from user Folding Doors Inward, one word. Next, we have, I think Seth Rollins is cool. And that came in after Hell in a Cell. I don't know how they still think Seth Rollins is cool, but all right. That comes from user DogRyan100. The next one is, I think wrestling sucks. From user BasedBigDog. You're not wrong. But I would say if you think wrestling sucks, maybe just don't watch as much WWE. Try out some other promotions. Maybe you'll like it again. Next we have Dynamite was good, but the spot where Darby fell off his skateboard onto Jericho and tickled his tummy is quickly becoming overrated. I would say you're wrong. I think we need more of Jericho's tummy getting tickled. I think he should maybe have his own segment every week where a different wrestler tickles his tummy. And the skateboard would have been a really great way to start that. That comes from user SC Scanland. And the final one of the week is the Lana Lashley Rusev angle isn't as bad as people are making it out to be. People are just offended by Vince/Heyman's interracial fetish and the fact this is some Attitude Era content. Hashtag doggy thoughts from user at the Road Dogster. Yeah, I mean, I've been saying for the last 2 weeks I really like this angle. I really like the Lashley Lana stuff where they have sex on TV. I love Rusev's mustache. And I really hope they push that this more. So that's all the hot takes for this week. I've been Hot Take Jake, your Deep Six champion. And I'll catch you next week with some more hot takes. Remember to like, comment, subscribe. Follow us on Twitter if you want to see our predictions. And come back for the rest of our videos that we do a couple times a week.